All right, everyone. Let's start the accountancy part. So in accounts, in previous class, we were discussing this chapter, rules of debit and credit. And this is going to be our last class in this chapter. So let's revise everything, first of all. Then only we will proceed further with this chapter. So till now, in this chapter, we have understood the meaning of account. So why do we need to know the meaning of account, or why we are basically required to know the various types of account? See, basically, rules regarding the debit and credit, rules of debit and credit, depends upon the type of account. So in order to decide what item and what transaction will be debited and what should be credited, we must understand what is account and what are the various types of account. So in this chapter, we have first started with the concept of accounts. So account, what I have told you, that account is basically a summarized record of transaction. All right. And we can categorize the accounts depending upon two different approaches of accounting. There is a accounting approach which is called modern accounting approach, and there is a traditional accounting approach of categorizing the accounts. So according to the modern accounting approach, we have categorized the accounts into five parts. First is, we have categorized as assets, then liability, then expenses and revenue, and finally capital. So these are the five accounts according to the modern accounting approach. And rule regarding these account, debit and credit rule applies like this. In case of asset, what we will do, whenever there is increase in asset, what we do, when there is increase asset, we debit the asset account. Whenever there is decrease in asset, we will credit the asset account. In case of liability, what we will do, whenever there is increase in liability, we will credit the liability account. Whenever there is decrease in liability, we will debit the liability account. Similarly, in case of expense, we basically increase in expense, debited; decrease in expense, credited. In case of revenue, increase in revenue basically credited, and again decrease in revenue is debited. And in case of capital account, different rule is applicable. In case of capital account, increase in capital leads to credit and decrease in capital is debited. So these are the rules regarding different types of account according to the modern accounting approach. Now we have in the last class discussed that there is one other approach of categorizing the accounts, that is traditional approach. And in traditional approach, we have categorized the account as personal account. Then we have real account and nominal account. In case of, basically, real account belongs to assets. All the assets account are called real account except few. There are certain exceptions. I have told you about the exception in the last class. And nominal accounts belong to all the revenue, expenses, income, and gains. Account related to all of these are basically called nominal account. And personal account, basically all the accounts which are related with the liabilities are personal account, including all those which are excluded in the real account are also part of personal account. All right. And in the previous class, we have also discussed the rules regarding the personal, real and nominal, rules of debit and credit in case of personal, real and nominal. So what is the rule of debit and credit in case of real account? Anyone? What is the rule of debit and credit in case of real account? In case of real account, because real account belongs to asset, we have understood that if there is increase in the asset,
debit.
Correct. In case of increase in asset, we will debit it. In case of decrease in asset, we will credit it. Correct. Perfect. So there is a statement used for this. We write it as debit what comes in. Debit what comes in. Credit what goes out. So you can write this statement as well. Debit what comes in, increase in asset, basically debit what comes in, debited. And when there is a decrease in the asset, this is called credit what goes out. So credit what goes out, basically credited. All right. Now there is rule regarding personal account. Personal account belongs to liability. So in case of liability, what we will do, increase in liability, what we will do?
Credit,
correct. And decrease in liability?
Debit,
correct. For this, we use this statement. Debit the receiver. Correct. Debit the receiver and credit the giver. And there is one last account, which is called nominal account. In case of nominal account, nominal accounts belongs to the account related to the revenue, expenses, gains and profits. So we write increase in revenue, expense, etc. What we will do? We will credit. Increase in revenue and expense is, just a minute, increase in losses and expenses credited. Increase in income and gains debit. All right. So here there is a statement which is called debit all expenses and gains. Debit all expenses and losses and credit all
income and gains.
So just a minute, there's a mistake. This is debit and this is credit. Okay. So these are the basically points that we have discussed in the previous class. Now, based on this concept, we will do few questions, and we will, in today's session, we will learn how to make the account. And after that, we are basically done with this chapter. Okay. So these points we have already discussed. I think we have done this question, no? On the basis of traditional accounting approach, identify the nature of account in the following cases.
Yes, we have done this.
Yeah. We have also done this question. Okay, these are the various rules of debit and credit. Okay. Now, see, this is the question. On which side will be the decrease in the following account recorded? Also identify the type of account according to the modern and traditional approach. So this is the question. You have to basically identify that which type of account these are according to the modern and traditional approach, and also you have to basically identify that or at which side these will be recorded if there is decrease in these account. Okay, so let's start this. Just a minute. So first of all, we will be preparing statement like this: name of account, traditional, consequence of decrease, and modern accounting. So let me solve this for you on the paper. First of all, name of account. where it will be categorized as per the modern accounting approach, as per the traditional accounting approach, and what will be the effect of decrease. Effect of decrease will be recorded at which
you
side
mean
of the
debit or credit?
Yeah.
Okay.
So all of these basically accounts are decreasing. This is already given in the question. So we just have to decide where it will be recorded. So cash is what? Cash is a kind of, tell me, cash is asset.
Yes.
Cash is asset. So according to modern accounting approach, we will call it what? It is an asset account, right? It is an assets account. But according to traditional accounting approach, we will call it
real
account. Perfect. Very good. And because there is decrease in the asset, we will
credit.
Very good. Nice. Now, second transaction. Second item is bank overdraft. So bank overdraft is what? Bank overdraft, we can write it as OD. Bank overdraft is what? Bank overdraft is a kind of asset, liability, expense or revenue. Tell me.
Liability.
According to, correct. So it is a liability account. Very good. And as per the traditional account, it will be categorized as
personal account.
Very good. Okay. And because there is decrease in the liability, what we will do?
Debit
or credit?
Debit.
Very good. Nice. Next, third. Third is outstanding rent. So outstanding rent is a kind of
liability
account, correct. And according to the traditional approach, it is a
personal account.
Very good. And because it is a personal account and outstanding rent is basically decreasing, so what we will do whenever there is decrease in the liability, we will debit it. Okay. Now fourth is prepaid insurance. Prepaid insurance is an asset, correct? So it is an asset account. But according to traditional account, it will be categorized under
real account.
No, it is not a real account. Though nominal. It is an asset, no, this is not a nominal account.
Personal.
So yes, this is personal. Obviously, there are only three options.
Yes, sir. Personal.
So this is personal because we have certain exception regarding the asset, that every asset is not included under the real account. Few assets are kept as an exception to the real account, it will be kept under the personal account. So prepaid insurance is basically a personal account. And
sir,
on personal, it basically belongs to a person. It must be in the name of some person. So basically it is a personal account. And because there is decrease in the asset, decrease in the personal account, what we will do?
Credit.
Debit. Prepaid insurance is an basically a personal account, so we will debit. Okay, now Mohan, proprietor of the business. Mohan, who is a proprietor. So proprietor is basically what? A capital account, right? Capital account. Okay. And according to the traditional account approach, Mohan will be categorized as personal account.
Personal account.
And there is decrease in the capital. There is debit. Okay, this is it. Are you writing this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
I think we have done in the fourth item. Prepaid insurance is an asset, no? So there is decrease in the value of asset. Yes, right. Samiksha, Halima,
yes, Veer.
Okay. Everyone else?
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
Okay, let's move to other question. Now, this is where we will start learning the how we will finally start learning about the how to make the account. So open a T-shape account for furniture and write the following transaction on the proper side. So this is the information we have to basically prepare the account. This is the information regarding furniture is given. Furniture purchase 50,000, furniture sold 10,000, furniture purchase again for 15,000. Old furniture have been discarded, depreciation on furniture. So all of these information is given. What we have to do, we are basically required to prepare the T-shape account. T-shape account is nothing but the account we are required to prepare for furnitures. Okay, give me a minute and let me show you how can we make the account. See, in the question, we have to prepare the account for furniture. So first of all, we will write the heading as furniture account. Okay. So, and furniture is what? Furniture is an asset, right? So because it is an asset, so on the furniture account, rule regarding the real account will apply, right? Because furniture is an asset, so which rule of debit and credit will be applicable? Rule regarding the real account. And real account rule regarding the real account says if there is increase in asset, just debit the increase. If there is decrease in asset, we will credit the decrease. So keep this in mind and prepare a furniture account. Furniture account will be prepared like this. This here we will make a column. We will also now this time we will make a column for date as well. Now, as usual, particulars. Then amount. Then again, date at which transaction is basically taking place and particular. And finally, amount. So these are the various columns that we'll have to draw in order to.
This is ledger, right?
This is, huh? Yeah, this is, you can say this is ledger for furniture.
Okay.
Ledger is a kind of account. So this is, we are making the account for furniture. So now, what are the various transactions given? See, first of all, transaction is furniture purchase 50,000. Tell me, when we purchase this furniture, what will happen? Whether there will be increase in the furniture or decrease in the furniture? Tell me. This is the debit side, this is the credit side. When we will purchase, furnitures will increase. And when furniture increases, what will we do? Where we will record this transaction? On the debit side. So we will write purchase furniture. And remember, whenever you purchase, cash goes out, right? Whenever you purchase, cash goes out. So I'm just writing here for reference that cash will go out. Cash, how much the value of furniture we are purchasing furniture for 50,000. So we have recorded the purchase of furniture on the debit side, right? Following the rule of debit and credit that applies on the real account. Now the second thing, second transaction is furniture sold for rupees 10,000. So tell me, when we will sell the furniture, what will happen to the furniture? It will increase or decrease? Tell me. There will be increase or decrease. Correct. So we will now, this will be recorded on the credit side, because any decrease in the asset will be recorded on the credit side. And because we have, what we are basically doing, we are selling the furniture. So when we will sell the furniture, we will receive certain cash. Okay. So I'm just indicating that cash will be received when we will sold the furniture.
So you didn't write furniture there in that column. Like cash, you wrote furniture is not written.
Yeah, there is table. In this table, there is no need to
explain it.
Sorry?
Can you explain this table?
I have written here, no? Furniture's account. And we have made these column date, particular amount. There is no need to mention furniture now. As you have already named the account, this account belongs to the furniture. So there is no need that you mention the furniture at every transaction, because you are purchasing the furniture. So there will be outflow of cash. So basically I have written that when we will purchase furniture, there will be cash involvement. Basically cash will go out, and when we will sell the furniture, there is no need to write the furniture. We will just write cash. All right. And how much the value of sale is 10,000. So we will write this at 10,000.
Okay. So Halima, one it's debited and next one it's credited.
Correct. Because in the second transaction, asset is decreasing. In the first transaction, asset was increasing. All right.
Okay, sir.
Now the third transaction is furniture purchase. What will happen if we will purchase the furniture? There will be increase or decrease in the asset?
Increase.
And because there is increase, we will write here. We have purchased the furniture again. Just a minute. We are purchasing, no? Yeah. So again, cash is involved for purchase of furniture. And we have purchased the furniture for rupees 15,000 this time. So 15,000 will be recorded here. Okay. Now, moving on further, old furniture discarded. So when we discard the old furniture, what will happen to the overall quantity of furniture? It will reduce or increases?
Decrease.
And because discarding of furniture reduces the overall quantity of furniture, so it will be recorded at the credit side. So furniture discarded. Always remember that whenever you discard furniture, it is a kind of loss. So furniture discarded, for the time being, I'm just writing the name of transaction, furniture discarded. But in the next, when we will make a next account, we will be using different name here. We will be writing profit and loss account. So we have discarded the furniture of 5,000. Okay. After that, depreciation on furniture. Depreciation is basically reduction in the value of furniture. Depreciation basically means there is a reduction in the value of furniture over the period of time. So let's suppose you have purchased the furniture at the beginning of the year for rupees 50,000, but at the end of the year, same furniture will basically have the lower value. Now, because you have purchased at the beginning, it has the value of 50,000, but at the end of the year, it will be only 40,000. So there is a reduction of 10,000 in the price of the furniture, and this is due to passage of time. This is called depreciation. So depreciation reduces the quantity of asset, reduces the assets. So it will also be recorded on the credit side, depreciation. Depreciation is also a kind of loss. So in the next account, we will be writing profit and loss account in place of depreciation. Depreciation is 3,000. All right. Is everything clear until now?
Yes, sir.
So what we are doing, sir, we are basically making a furniture account. We have initially purchased furniture of 50,000. So we have debited because it will increase the value of furniture. Then we have sold then again we have purchase, debit again, but and after that we have discarded few furnitures, then there is depreciation. Now every transaction, we have recorded every transaction. Now is the time to close this account. Always remember that at the time of closure of account, both the sides, both the debit and credit side should tally. Both the sides should tally. So when you total this side, debit side, this is 65,000. But when you will total this side, this is less than 65,000. How much is this? 10,000 plus 5,000 plus 3,000. This is only 18,000, right? So basically, we will write the balance of the furniture. This is the total amount of furniture we have. We have the total amount of furniture, 65,000, out of which we have sold 10,000. We have discarded 5,000. We have the depreciated furniture, 3,000. So how much furniture we are left with? What is the amount of furniture that we are currently having? 65,000 less 10,000 less 5,000 less 3,000. How much? Calculate and tell me how much will be left. See, 47,000. 47. Correct. So now when you will total both the sides, both the sides will tally. So we will write the balance figure as 47,000 here. So you can note it down, or you can note it from here as also.
Sir?
Yes, Ameeksha.
Now we have just added 47,000, right? Now what will we do with that?
Like, we haven't added anything. We just calculated the balance figure of furniture. We have purchased 50,000. Again, we have purchased furniture 15,000. So we have total of 65,000 furnitures, right? After that, we have sold 10,000. We have discarded 5,000. There is a depreciation of 3,000. So what is the amount of furniture that we are basically left with? So this is the balancing figure of furniture. So we haven't added anything. We have just calculated the balancing figure of the furniture. Everybody done? Everyone?
Yes, sir. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now, let's move on to the other question. See, this is the question. Open a T-shape account for machinery and put the following transaction on the proper side. So these are the five transactions you have. In this case, you have to prepare the machinery account, machinery purchase, machinery sold, machinery. We have purchased a machinery again, sold machinery, and finally depreciation on machinery. So try this question, try to attempt this, try to solve this question. And I'll, after that you are done, I will show you the answer. Let me know if you face any difficulty. Machinery account is also an asset account, so rule of a real account will be applicable.
Yes, sir. Done,
everyone?
No, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Okay, Halima. Halima, you are still doing?
Yes, I am doing.
All right, no problem. Take your time. Peer, any doubt? Any difficulty you are having?
No, sir.
Okay. Steve, what about you? You are also trying. Steve never answers.
Sir, this everything is assets, sir. Is everything assets?
Yeah, all these transactions are related to machinery, no? So machinery is a kind of asset.
Okay, sir.
See, first of all, what is happening here, we are basically purchasing machinery. So because machinery is an asset and we are purchasing machinery, it will increases the value of machinery, it will increases the assets. So it will be recorded on the debit side. So how we will write it? See, I'm basically adding one more thing here. Basically, when you purchase the machinery, there will be outflow of cash, right? So we will write, we will just write cash account here. Instead of writing purchase, I am writing cash. Okay. And how much there will be outflow of cash? Cash will be 40,000 of cash will be used for the purchase of machinery. Is it clear, everyone? So instead of writing purchase here, I have wrote cash account. All right. Next. In the next transaction, machinery sold. When we will sell the machinery, what will happen? Cash will comes in, right? Because we have sold the machinery, there will be decline in machinery. So it is clear that it will be recorded on the credit side. But because there will be inflow of cash, you know, on account of sale of machinery, we will write here also cash account. Is it clear, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So yes, we are writing 10,000 here. Okay. Now the third transaction is machinery purchase again. So when we purchase the machinery again, what will be used again, sir? We will use cash. I'm assuming that we are actually purchasing the asset every time for cash. We can also use bank, but for the time being, I'm just assuming that we are purchasing the machinery for cash. So cash again, we have purchased machinery of 8,000. We will write 8,000 here. After that, machinery sold again for 14,000. So when we will sell the machinery again, it will lead to inflow of cash again because machinery is decreased. So it will be recorded on the credit side, but because there is a cash inflow, so we will use the name cash account, 14,000. All right. Okay, now there is a depreciation on machinery. So I have told you that depreciation is a kind of loss. So instead of writing depreciation, I am gonna write here profit and loss account. Profit and loss account. What is the amount of depreciation? Depreciation is 1,000. Okay, is everyone clear? Any doubt? So this basically indicates that we have purchased machinery. We have purchased machinery for cash. We have purchased machinery for cash. We have sold machinery for cash. We have sold machinery for cash. And there is a depreciation, which we have basically recorded as profit and loss account. This is depreciation. Now, one more thing. Whenever you record anything on the credit side, we always use buy. This has been done traditionally, basically in order to prepare the account. Whenever we record anything on the credit side, we always use buy, and whenever we record anything on the debit side, we always use to. These are basically traditional terms that we use while preparing the account. In order to record any transaction on the credit side, we use buy, so buy cash, and whenever we are recording anything on the debit side, we will use to. So two can be two cash or two anything. Now, again, there will be buy and two. Is everybody clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, finally, time balance. To tally both the sides. So we have 48,000 of furnitures here. And we have sold 10,000, 14,000, 1,000. So what will be the balancing figure? Sorry?
25,000 balance.
25,000 will be balance. And we will write it as buy balance. And both the sides will now tally 48,000 and 48,000. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So you can also prepare the machinery account like this. But in the solution that I have shown you, I haven't used the term like cash sold and cash purchase. I haven't used the purchase and sold terms. So instead of writing this, this is understood. If there is a cash, it simply means that you have purchased machinery. If there is a cash, this indicates that we have purchased machinery. If there is a cash on the credit side, simply means we have sold machinery for cash. We have sold machinery for cash. And again, this will be recorded as profit and loss account, depreciation, and finally the balance. All right. Now, there is one more question. Try this. Now, write the basically the way I have shown you the solution. Open a T-shaped account of creditor and write the following transaction on the proper side. Purchase goods from Mohan credit, Mohan on credit, paid to Mohan, goods returned to Mohan, repurchase goods from Mohan on credit. So if we are purchasing goods from Mohan on credit, can you tell me who is Mohan for us? Who is Mohan for us?
Creditor.
Creditor, correct. And creditor comes under the personal account. So rule regarding the personal account will be applicable. Try. Whenever you open an account for the creditor or the debtor, you always open the account with the name of the debtor or creditor. All right. There is no need to write creditor's account or debtor's account. You just have to write the name of the person. So we will open an account with the name of Mohan, Mohan account. Samiksha, are you done?
Yes. Sir, here is good return. So it's credited.
Goods returned. What we will do, we have purchased goods and now we are returning the goods. So it will be
debit, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Sir, this will be like the opposite of the machinery account, right?
Yes, because it is basically a liability account.
Okay.
C see what will happen. We are basically purchasing goods on credit from Mohan. So we will write, because we are purchasing, so we will write, because we are not paying cash this time, we will use by purchase this time. By purchase, we are purchasing good on credit, so there is no inflow of, sorry, there is no outflow of cash. So by purchase account, and we have purchased goods of 50,000. So this is 50,000. All right. Now the second transaction is paid to Mohan 30,000. So because we are basically paying to Mohan, and payment will be done in cash, so we will use to cash account, or else you can also use to cash only. So to cash will be 30,000. After that, third transaction is good return to Mohan. All right, good return to Mohan. Basically, your liability is decreasing. You have purchased goods of 50,000 from Mohan. Now you are returning the goods to Mohan, so it will reduce your liability. No, and whenever there is reduction in the liability, what we will do? We will
debit it
to purchase return. We will write it as purchase return.
Sir?
Yes.
You had told that if it's credit, we can also write bank account.
Yes, we can write bank account.
So in the first one, can we also write by, instead of purchase account, can we write by bank account also?
No, sorry. Repeat your question again.
Sir, it's written to Mohan by credit, right?
Yes.
So can you also write bank account?
Bank account will mean that you have paid Mohan through bank. If we will write here bank, it will simply mean that we are making payment to Mohan through bank. So basically it will not be a credit purchase, no? So here we will write by purchase account only. We will not write cash or bank anything. Otherwise it will not be a credit purchase.
Yes.
Okay. Now here we will write to purchase return. And value of purchase return was 3,000. So here will be 3,000. Now, after this, repurchase goods from Mohan on credit. Again, we have purchased goods from Mohan. So we will again write by purchase account. And this time we have purchased goods costing 10,000. So this is 10,000. Now we will tally again. This side is 60,000. We have total of 60,000 purchases. We have made the payment for 30,000 and 33,000 return. Sorry, 3,000 return. So ultimately, we have the final liability of how much?
27,000.
It will be written where? On which side? This side is less than this side. All right. Yes. So in order to tally, we will write to balance. CD is generally used. CD, this is called carried down. So 27,000. Both the sides will now tally 60,000, 60,000. Anyone having any doubt? Peer, Steve, Halima?
No doubt.
Any problem? Okay, no doubt. So this is how we present it. Okay, now one more question. This is from the following particulars. Prepare the account of D. Buddhi Raja, the proprietor of business. Capital introduced, 30,000 drawing made by him. Further capital introduced, profit for the period 75,000. So consider Buddhi Raja is a proprietor. So we'll have to prepare proprietor's account, right? We will have to prepare Buddhi Raja proprietor account. And Buddhi Raja, because he's a proprietor, so this account will fall into the category of personal account, right?
Personal account.
So rule regarding the personal account will be applicable. And what is the rule regarding the personal account? Personal account basically says that
there's an increase, it's credited, and there's a decrease, it's debited.
Very good. Try this question. we will write proprietor's account.
Sir, for capital introduced, what will write, sir?
Capital introduced, it is increasing the capital.
Yes, sir. Right?
So, whenever there is increase in capital, we will credit it.
Yes, sir. No, what we will write, capital account?
You can write to capital or to cash. Capital, in case of capital, what will come, whenever capital is introduced, what will happen? Cash will be brought into the business. No, so we will write it as, because capital is being introduced, so we will write it as cash. Okay. Assuming that he brought the capital in the form of cash only.
Sir, profit means increase in capital.
Yes, profit will lead to the increase in capital. So by profit and loss account, 7500 will be recorded in the credit side of the both proprietor's account.
Okay, sir.
All right, see, this is how we will prepare this account. First of all, because 30,000 has been introduced by Buddhi Raja, so it will be recorded on the credit side of this account by cash 30,000. All right. And after this, he is withdrawing 6,500. So we will prepare a different account and we will write it as, So he is basically withdrawing 6,500. We will write it as true drawing on the debit side. Drawing will reduce the amount of capital of Buddhi Raja. So because capital is decreasing, we will debit the decrease in capital and we will write it as true drawing. This indicates that there is decrease in the value of capital of Buddhi Raja because he has drawn 6,500 from the business. All right. After that, further capital is introduced. So because he's introducing further capital of 22,000, we will write again on the credit side because there is increase in the capital. So it will be recorded on the capital, okay, credit side of the capital account. So by cash 22,000 again, we have introduced 22,000 again. All right. After that, there is information that profit for the period is 7,500. Proprietor have earned, or the capital on the amount that he have invested, it has earned him 7,500 of profit. So this profit will add to the value of capital, right? It will increase the overall capital of the proprietor. So it will be credited again, 7,500. Why profit is being credited? Because it will increase the value of capital. So the final figure will be 30,000, 22,000 plus 7,500 equals to 59,500. But debit side only have 6,500 balance. Sorry, 6,500. So in order to balance, we will find the balancing figure and it will be 53,000. Now we will tally both the side, 59,500 and 59,500. Is it clear, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Peer, Mazen, Halima.
Yes.
Any doubt? Sir. Any problem?
No, sir.
No, sir, no doubt.
Okay, very good. Now, this is the, I think this is the last question. No, we have one more question after this. See, this is a question from the following particulars. Prepare the proprietor's capital account. This is the information regarding 2013. See, year, basically, let me tell you one more thing in or before starting this concept. See, our year in accounts, year starts from April 1st. And ends on 31st of March next year. All right. So let's suppose we are talking about 2021 and 22. So our accounting year have started in the year 1st April 2021. And it will end on 31st March in the year 2022. All right. So start April. 1st April till the 31st March 2022, this will be considered as a single year. This, if suppose, let's suppose information in the question is given like this, that customer have or the basically proprietor is incurring certain expenses in the year 2021, and there is information regarding the 2022 as well. So you will consider it as the single year, as the 1 year, and you will prepare the one account for this. So in this question, there is information that in the year 2013, business have started on 1st April with the capital of 45,000 and proprietor have withdrawn 10,000 on May 10. Then again, July 5, 15, he have introduced certain amount of capital. On November 30, he have paid income tax. And in the on 2014, finally profit he made is 30,000. So this is the, this is basically end of the year, 30,000. So try to attempt this question, try to solve this question. I'm sure you will be able to do this. This is similar to the last question. In this case also, we have to prepare the proprietor's capital account only.
Sir, so the cash increases, we have to credit.
Yes. It will be credited because we are talking about the capital account.
Okay, sir.
So transaction start on 1st April 2013. We will write by cash 45,000. See, this is the proprietor's capital account. And on 1st April 2013, what is happening? Proprietor is basically starting business with capital of 45,000. So we will record it as buy cash 45,000. After this, he have withdrawn 10,000 on May 10. So we will write it here. 10th May 2013. How we will write it? Two drawings.
Two drawings.
Correct, two drawings. And how much he have withdrawn? 10,000. So we will write here 10,000. After that, third transaction is on July 15. Further capital is introduced. So we will, because there is increase in capital, so we will write it on the credit side. 15th of July 2013.
By cash.
And by cash. How much cash he is bringing in?
5,000.
Sorry?
55,000.
55,000 again as capital. And after this, he has paid income tax. See, income tax is a kind of personal expenditure.
Law.
this is not a business expenditure, right? What is basically proprietor doing? Proprietor is basically paying his income tax from the capital of the business, right? So this will be treated as a any withdrawal, any payment for his personal purpose will be considered as what?
Drawing.
Correct. So it will be recorded as drawings to drawings account. Just a minute. So here it will be written as two drawings. November 30. Drawing is 5,000. Okay. So two drawing 5,000. After that, he have also earned profit on 31st March. So we will write here as by what we will write? By for profit, what by we cash? Will write? No. Profit, whenever there is profit or loss, we will use profit and loss account, P&L, profit and loss account. And how much of profit he have earned? He have earned 30,000 of profit. So we will write as profit and loss account, 30,000. This is it. This is done. Now there is...
Sir, with profit, loss also is there. Profit and loss account together.
Yeah, basically, whenever you write, whenever there is profit or there is a loss, we will use this account to record the transaction, profit and loss account. See, this is going to be a different account. No, if there is profit, it will be recorded in the profit and loss account. If there is a loss, it will also be recorded in the profit and loss account. So what we are basically doing here, we are basically mentioning the account where the profit and loss profit you will be able to find. So we are just referring the name of the account where the profit will be available. So by profit and loss account. Okay. So now we will tally both the sides for 45,000, 55,000 and 30,000. Let me check the total value. Just a minute. So total will be 1,30,000. And there will be a balance figure of 1,15,000. So we will write the balance as to balance. What we will do now? To balance BD, brought, sorry, CD. To balance carried down. 115,000. Now both the sides will tell you 1,30,000, 1,30,000. And this is the balance on which date? This is the balance of 31st March. 31st March 2013. Sorry, 2014. This is also 2014. Tell me, everyone, is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay, let's do the last question. Let me check the time. Just a minute. Can you do this question in homework? Open a T-shaped account for of debtor bridge. Okay, and sir. This is similar to the questions we have done. In this case also, you have to prepare basically a creditor account. Sorry, in this case, we have to open a debtor account. Okay. And debtor is basically an asset. So rule regarding the real account will be applicable. Sole goes to bridge on credit. Cash received from bridge, discount allowed to him. There is a possibility that you might face a little problem in this question, but never mind, try to solve this. Okay. And I will be sharing this slide today. I didn't share this slide yesterday because there are certain slides that I required to add. So I will share this slide today and you can refer the solution here. All right. So this will be your homework. I'll be sharing few more questions as your homework today. So for the time being, you just take the screenshot of this and try to solve this question as your homework. Okay, Sameeksha and Mazen, Peer, yes. Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt you want to ask? So we are done with this chapter. No. We finished this chapter. We will be starting a new chapter in the next class. Probably Either we will start general entry, general chapter of general entry, or either we will start cash book. So at that I will decide. So one of the chapter that we will start in the next class.
Okay.
Yes, Veer.
Sir, this one debtor.
Yeah, this is a debtor.
So if the cash increases, you have to debit.
Yes.
Okay.
So see, let me help you. Sold goods to bridge on credit. So it will, what will happen? Sales. It will be recorded as to sales. Just to like sales. We have, when we purchase goods on credit, we write by purchase. Whenever we sell goods on credit, we write to sales on the debit side. And after that, cash received from bridge. So it will be recorded on which side? By cash on the credit side, right? And discount allowed is a kind of what? Discount allowed is a kind of expense. It is a kind of loss, right? So it will be recorded as by profit and loss account.
Okay.
Okay. And goods returned by bridge, it will be what? It will reduces the value of asset. When bridge return the goods, it will reduces the value of asset. It will reduces the value of debtor. Initially, he basically bought the goods of ₹25,000 from you. Now he's returning goods of 5,000. So now there will be reduction in the value of debtor. So let's just see the solution of this question. I'll be sharing other question and you can practice on those questions. So this is the solution. But I would basically recommend you to try all of these questions by yourself once, and it will give you a lot of confidence in this chapter. So for the time being, this is it. In this chapter, we will be starting a new chapter in the next class. Practice and revise everything as much as you can in order to get more and more confidence with these chapters. All right, everyone. So this is it from my side. We'll see you tomorrow with a new chapter. All right, everyone.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Allah.
Allah. Thank you.